So the final race on day one of week four then is the Betfred Middleton Stakes. It's a 1.25 mile event, group two, 4 year olds and upwards. Top one is Cantonia, Derek Hinton, Golden Gate Bridge and Grandioso, Paul Rhodes, Miss Millennium, Molly at Surfer, Mullier, Tavern King, Risk of Youth, Darren Thompson, Teacher's Pet, Django and Teller, Hans Jones. So eight of them then in this, which I'm pretty sure was a fillies race, but all in. And away they go. Oh, completely level break just about, with Teacher's Pet on the near side. Probably now just going to be the one to lead. Rhodes has got two in this, and the lighter coloured horse is Grandioso. The darker coloured horse is Golden Gate Bridge. But it's Teacher's Pet who's gone to the rail and is in the lead. And settling down in front, then they're already through the first couple of furlongs, and Teacher's Pet is in the lead from Grandioso up the centre of the track. The grey on the rail is Muller. Golden Gate Bridge just behind them. Then Teller is also pretty close up with Miss Millennium in the yellow sleeves. Right over on the inside rail is Risk of Youth, and Cantonia in the pink jacket is just the back marker. So Teacher's Pet takes them along, and the pace doesn't look too hot. Grandioso is second. Then comes Muller in third. Golden Gate Bridge is fourth. And then Teller, Miss Millennium, Cantonia, and finally Risk of Youth. But Teacher's Pet in the yellow continues to lead past the sixth then. From Grandioso poking his head in a second, the yellow sleeve Miss Millennium in those old Molly at Surfer colours is next. Bursting through on the inside is Teller. Then comes Grandioso. Golden Gate Bridge just caught a bit flat footed and is now looking for room and has dropped to the back, but it's Teacher's Pet in the lead. Teacher's Pet leads by two lengths to Grandioso, Muller, and Teller. Then comes Risk of Youth, Miss Millennium, Cantonia, and Golden Gate Bridge. Plenty still in the chances, four furlongs to go. And Teacher's Pet's in front from Muller, who's now been angled out for a run. And Grandioso trying to box it in, and Grandioso comes up on the outside. And now comes the throwdown, a big challenge to Teacher's Pet. Muller caught a bit flat footed, Teller trying to run on. So to his Golden Gate Bridge, but it's Teacher's Pet and Grandioso are three or four lengths clear. It's Teacher's Pet who's got the rail. Grandioso is trying to read him in. There's still two furlongs to go. Teacher's Pet is about a neck in front of Grandioso. These are clear of Muller, who started to run again. Then Golden Gate Bridge, Risk of Youth after that one. But it's Teacher's Pet still in the lead, but only by about a head now. Then past the furlong pole, Teacher's Pet, Grandioso suddenly asserts, and Grandioso hits the front. Teacher's Pet's got no more, and Grandioso is going to race up towards the line, taking a good big quick double for Paul Rhodes up towards the line. Grandioso takes it, and the fast finishing Muller. Golden Gate Bridge was also there at the death as well, but Grandioso needed the line in the end, just starting to tie up in those final strides, but hangs on to win it by a good half a length. Muller is second, actually it's Mullier, isn't it? Golden Gate Bridge is third. So Grandioso for Paul Rhodes takes it, Mullier for Tam King is second, Golden Gate Bridge for Paul Rhodes third, Teacher's Pet for Django fourth, and Cantonia for Derek Hinton was fifth. That's all for day one.